Welcome back at ThingsCon 2016 in Amsterdam in the hotel. With me is Jan de Waal. Jan, you're in the capacity as a part of Clicknl. What is Clicknl?
Clicknl is a public institution which connects researchers with the creative industries.
And Clicknl is a sponsor of ThingsCon because IoT is an important part for Clicknl?
Definitely. I think IoT is a very interesting topic now for designers in the entire creative industry. Kind of similar with the emerging of the internet a few decades ago. We saw a lot of makers, designers from different disciplines work together on all kinds of new possibilities. And I think the IoT wave is even faster, so I think it's a good thing that we're here making it possible.
One of the good things, the great things, I think, of the ThingsCon is that you actually have these different kind of people here, and it actually is more designers, I think, than that there is actual hardware developers or something. Is it your influence?
Maybe, I don't know. Of course, it's our background, but at the same time, those disciplines are blurring. There are a lot of designer makers, for example, or it's not that separate disciplines anymore. That's important because I think we shouldn't leave all these kind of developments, all these new emerging technologies to the big industries only. As a designer, you can make proof of concepts. You can, especially if you of course join a team with experts from different fields, you're going to make much better solutions, more value for the end user.
Now, Internet of Things is hard to describe for me, and because I heard many people talking about it and many definitions. So what is Internet of Things for you?
Well, let's make it a little abstract, but I think it's the integration between physical and the virtual. So we're not so interested with products with an app. I mean, that's of course that stage. Creating services, creating solutions for people where the sensors, big data are integrated to one simple solution that really provides value. That's the biggest challenge, and that's what designers do.
It is a challenge. Are there certain examples emerging already that we can see as a simple consumer on an everyday basis?
Right. Plenty of them, of course, varying from like the bumper belt, which is you don't know it. It's for premature babies to monitor. Also at home, which allows the babies to get out of the hospital more early. That's one of the projects we were involved as well. And that is quite interesting because it saves, of course, a lot of healthcare costs. But at the same time, it's kind of for parents, it's a different story because they're responsible for that preborn child. So it's a very interesting design problem because how are we going to create such a service? Another example, of course.
Go back to the baby belt, bumble belt. So, I think a few years ago, one could have said that it's a quite self project. It's now an IoT project. So, what is the difference, or what makes this a typical IoT project?
It of course, Quantify itself is also technology based, right? And I think, but the technology on sensoring, on data clouds, on intelligence, transforming those data into a real value, it's rapidly changing the way we look into applications and that kind of digital design. So it's all about the same, and it's about connecting the physical world to a digital environment and on a massive scale, and on a scale which is also not only massive because of all the sensing, the small sensorings, but also of the scales of the economics. So I think we're currently flooded with IoT stuff which doesn't make any value yet, and the big challenge is of course to not have about 300 apps in your phone all committing to a specific product, have others kind of service, a kind of user interaction, which makes in order to make our lives easier.
One of these these new technologies that we hear about these days, especially these conferences, is AI, and the other one is conversational interfaces. Are they becoming playing a bigger role in this industry?
Yes, of course. I mean, well, you know what the most challenging actually is of course, that, at one hand, there's tremendous investments also in IT platforms, IBM, a few billions, on AI, Watson's, that's also IBM, but also the other big players. And at the same time, we have those, especially here on ThingsCon, designers making new products, trying out new domains, adding value. So how are they going to work together? And what does it mean to IP? What does it mean to privacy? What does it mean to open access? It's still to be tested. It's still to be developed. And we still have to make pretty a lot of steps with it.
Yeah. Are there things that you just mentioned, privacy and security, and things that is ClickNL involved in these topics? Are they working on these subjects?
Yes. ClickNL itself doesn't do any research, of course. We provide funds, roadmap through government institutions to do research and creative agency to do innovation and research. So, but one of our roadmaps, as we call them, is virtual worlds, for example. And that's not only creating a VR experience, this is to my mind. So those are more fundamental research in order to enlarge the knowledge base of designers. So when you develop or design an application, you're aware of the privacy issues, or you're aware of the identity issues, etc. So yes, we definitely are creating roadmaps, creating programs to tackle those issues. And at the same time, we're also having roadmap more on an innovation basis, where we try to innovate with industries like health or with energy to come up with new solutions. And those, of course, intermediate or intermix, and which makes it very interesting.
There's a lot of designers walking around here in at this conference. Is thinking about the ethics and security and everything, is it already part of curriculum in most design schools, or does it need more attention?
Well, traditionally, especially from architecture and design, that has been the case. Now, from a digital design or a gaming perspective, that's, I wouldn't say new, but it's an aspect we should definitely be taking care as well. I think designers do, and designers designing education do have that history, that heritage. So also our industry, of course, is blurring, right? So designer principles, designing methods, and mapping that towards the value of ethics, aesthetics, as well as economics, is a ball game, and that's quite an interesting ball game as well.
Do you also take the findings that you learn from conferences like this to the government, or do you talk to Parliament or European Union or lobby for certain things about IoT?
Yes, for sure. That's I think the most important reason of existence of ClickNL. Match the bridge between top-down programs like the Nationale Wetenschapsagenda, well, bottom as well, but or European programs and what's happening in the field. Using the metaphor that it's not R&D anymore, it becomes more and more DNR. We design a solution and let's research the results and design another one. Another. So that shift in paradigm also implies that there's more, there should be and is more influence from bottom up. Developments like things happening at ThingsCon into what kind of program do we need. And it's also how Click is organized for those roadmaps, for those programs we use designers, researchers for input and make it happen.
Now, traditionally, some European governments tend to say no to new things because they don't understand them. How is the situation in the Netherlands right now?
I'm quite positive, actually. And I don't want to talk about budgets and stuff. Of course, it always can be better, and especially for fundamental research, applied research. It really is paying back. So hopefully a new cabinet will at least increase it again, because also more social stuff, like what's the real value of movements like these, creative industry to creative economy, how does could it contribute to, in the end, our well-being? So, yes, I am quite positive that there's a lot of energy. There was a big chance that we have defined a few global challenges, energy transition, etc. And how does that convert to what's happening over there? How can we help those people to tackle those kind of problems? And, but I'm quite positive. There's a lot of things happening, and it's not traditional. It's really bottom up and top down combined in all kinds of ways, on all kinds of domains. So I'm positive.
Oh, that's always good. I think it was last week we saw a movement in the European Union where they're trying to create a one single digital market. And are you part of that as well?
Well, not personally, but of course through all kinds of committees, yes. Especially to also, of course, guard the interests of the creative industry. For example, IP on the digital end is quite important. As an SME sector, we're very depending on IP. But we're also dependent on open access. We're building on each other's work. So open access is important, whether it's open data, open API, but also open innovation. So matching those, well, sometimes contradicting forces is quite important, especially on a European level. But I mean, I must say that also from a European perspective, creative industries, creative economy is getting far more attention. So on the right level, so I'm also hopeful on that.
Very hopeful, very good, Jan. And since we're in an Internet of Things conference, and how is it with you? How many devices do you have? How do you use it in your personal life?
Well, coming here to this conference, I really saw that there has to be a lot to be done on really, say, better interface, because it was by app state a slight drizzle, and I can tell you it was very heavy drizzle, so it was completely soaked the small. So in that sense, I'm connected, but I think should be even more connected or better connected. So I'm not a actually. Well, I've been into this area for all my life, but still I'm not that gadget freak. No. So I should say in between.
So what does it mean that in order to get to use IoT products, you have to move from a gadget phase to a next phase in the whole industry and
yes, and from two. I think from two perspectives. Also, I mean, I'm involved in a few of products, and I have a technical background, engineering background. I'm still shocked how difficult it is to get a prototype, successfully prototype to the production stage, especially with hardware. And scaling up with software is far more easier. Depending, of course, on the amount of traffic, etc. But combining those two worlds and also have an economic business model around it, well, it's quite a challenge. So and you can see it all over the place now that we all can still get the one product with the one app or the sensor with one app or trying. So there will be a lot of in between products before we have the ultimate IoT infrastructure ecosystem. So there's a lot to be gained, but again, hopeful. Things are moving fast. As long as we can really connect also the big movement, but big industries, but also our clients, then now things can happen. So.
All right, nice things are going to happen. Probably we hear from next year at ThinkCon 2017. Thank you very much, Jan.